It's 111 years since the All Blacks and Wales first met in international rugby, and the result of that game in favour of the Welsh remains controversial, but it set the scene for what has been a remarkable rivalry down the years. The results very much favour the All Blacks, and here at Eden Park, a New Zealand fortress, they'll start as the hot favourites to add to their 27 wins in this, the 31st match of these two great rugby nations. So the Welsh are here for three test matches, and here they come down the tunnel at Eden Park, and they'll be greeted by a capacity crowd. And Ian Smith is sidelined with conditions.
Yes, soaking it all up, Grant. What a great pipe opener to the season here in New Zealand. Perfect conditions. The Welsh are going to enjoy it here tonight. It's very mild. Conditions underfoot are very firm indeed, even though there's been rain around the Auckland area. They're going to run out onto a good surface, and they're going to play into a slight breeze playing from right to left.
It is a great rivalry and a big night for Alan Wynne-Jones as he comes out in front, playing 100 test matches. Let's meet the remainder of this Welsh side, and it's a good solid front row. Gethin Jenkins has been playing for Wales since 2002. The middle row, well, Alan Wynne-Jones, as we say, remarkable milestone, 100 tests, the fifth Welshman to do so. Sam Warburton leads from the open side flank for Wales. As we go into the back line, Rhys Webb, a very good halfback, and Dan Bigger is really the man who has to do the goal kicking. Jamie Roberts and Jonathan Davis, the big midfield, and the finishers. Alam Amos, a newcomer really. George North, an established player, and Liam Williams, and the players who will make up the bench for the Welsh tonight. So let's introduce now former All Black Justin Marshall.
Yes, good evening, Grant, and welcome everybody as Kieran Reid leads the All Blacks out for the 10th time. 84 test caps for him. Certain no stranger, A, to captaincy, and B, the big test match environment. He'll burst out onto Eden Park very shortly in front of a full house to watch the All Blacks at home for the first time since being crowned Rugby World Cup champions in 2015. Listen to that. Steve Hansen has named a formidable front row, Joe Moody, Dane Coles and Owen Franks, to complete the tight five. No Sam Whitelock, but Luke Romano and Brodie Retallick combine once again in the back row. Captain Kieran Reid is joined by Jerome Kano and Sam Kane to complete the All Black forward pack for this evening. To the back line, Aaron Smith and Aaron Cruden have played plenty of rugby together. A lot of talk about what's going to happen in the centres tonight. Ryan Crotty and Malachi Fekitoa have both played a test before. And to the back three, Ben Smith, Julian Sevier, and Waisaki Naholo gets his opportunity on the right wing. Harris, Crockett, Faumuida, Tuipulotu, Sevier, Piranara, Barrett, and Tamani Valu round out the 23.
Now the haka. And the big question, who leads the haka? First haka of 2016, and what a beauty.
Certainly was. Lots of passion, no doubt about it. And Aaron Smith with responsibility, and didn't he lead it well?
Yeah. Wayne Barnes of England in charge of this test match. And his assistant referees, Jaco Piper from South Africa, Will Houston from Australia, yeah. And another Australian is the television match official, George Ayoub. What a scene, what a sight. Yeah. Eden Park, a wonderful rugby arena. And we're about to get going. The international season of 2016.
You know which way you're going at?
And the All Blacks with some veteran players joined by some new boys on the block. It's the beginning of a new era in All Black rugby. They come to Eden Park as the world champions. But that's all behind them now.
You're good to go. Just
as
make
they
sure
prepare
they
to face the Welsh.
Time you run, fellas.
31st international between New Zealand and Wales is underway as it's kicked off by Aaron Cruden. And Wales have it outside the 22 with Reece Webb. And they're going to try and pull the All Black defenders in as Wyn Jones,
inside,
the centurion
inside.
Tonight, gets
just hold forward,
an early
hold.
Touch. The make kick going downfield where Ben Smith waits. And the All Blacks spin it away through Cruden to Julian Savier, who breaks a couple of tackles and got the pass away to Kane. Just on the Welsh side of halfway as Aaron Smith moves it across field. And the All Blacks have it under control through Ryan Crotty.
No, 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 five.
And the ball taken away,
that
but it's a
right
penalty. They were
second,
warned
second
to leave it. The temptation was too great. And Wyn Jones just
right.
arguing the point. And so this early penalty, and the All Blacks will have a look here. And yes, Cruden is going to have a shot about 50 on the angle.
Yeah, quite possibly at the end of his range. That's why I think he was contemplating it.
I didn't think
he does kick at 72% in test matches, Cruden, but a great first touch from Sevier. He set up that right foot step. They saw it coming, but he was just too powerful. Half broke the line, then a nice offload. Gethin Jenkins is over the ball there, but he doesn't have a hold of the ball. He had a hold of the All Black player, so you've got to be on the ball to win the ball, to win a penalty. Alwyn Jones, hands in the ruck, did plead his innocence. However, Wayne Barnes got it right, and an early chance for Cruden. Not really any wind to speak of, Smithy.
Nah, just a little behind him, to be fair. He's got the advantage of just his effort, so I don't think it's a huge factor. What a confidence builder this would be. One of the big question marks about this All Black side, who would be the next Carter with the boot. First chance for Aaron Cruden.
Long first up kick for Cruden. Gets it up nice and high. Distance is good. Off the post it goes. Now who can claim the ball? The All Blacks have got it through Coles. And here is Retallick. Great attacking options here for the All Blacks. They're only 10 metres away as Aaron Smith sends it wide. Gets it across to Cruden. Puts the little kick in. The chasers are coming, but under control for Liam Williams. And it'll be a restart from the 22.
Take your time,
and he might have just copped a knee as he took the ball in.
I think he just got hit hard by Kieran Reid, who was flying through.
Just make sure you're all right, mate.
He absolutely hammered him. Boy, what an opportunity for the All Blacks, though. I think Brody Retallick should have shifted it, and Waisaki Naholo will back me up. This is the read. Oh, it's slightly high. He's just got him with Mace mostly with the knee.
Good news. Sweet strike from Cruden, wasn't it? He definitely had the range there. It was halfway up the upright. Bad news, Wales so careless with that kick coming back and not contesting. Too many All Blacks getting their hands on the ball from that.
So the restart from Dan Bigger gives it a good thump down as far as Naholo. Now here's Smith. Just on the Welsh side of halfway, lays it back for Aaron Smith. Naholo in the move again and almost getting away from Jonathan Davis. Lays it nicely for Aaron Smith. All Blacks charging onto it through Kane. He's got them offside here, so they're playing under advantage as they crunch it up through Romano. And another player lying over the ball. That's another penalty, which is a lot closer than the first one. And Cruden gets it away as far as Kieran Reid. And the continuity continues. And over the 22 goes Brody Retallick. Now Smith called Sevier on the inside. Still playing under this advantage, of course, as Aaron Smith spins it wide. And Romano bounces a player out of the road. That was Moriarty. And now Cruden kicks again. Naholo getting there but can't quite bring it under control. So back they go. There were two penalties issued, and they'll take the second one, which is now in a handy position.
Yeah, it is right out in front. The first one slightly harder for Cruden. They'll take this opportunity right out in front of the post. They'll probably turn this early pressure into points, but it's looking ominous already for Wales. Certainly the ruck speed they're not coping with. Look at the charge from Romano's featured two or three times early. Here's the penalty. Plays advantage from there, and as it comes back, Cruden spotted the opportunity, just didn't get the execution right.
Playing with confidence, though, Aaron Cruden. That is, it's been a very good start. Some lovely touches, lovely little kicks through. Just a fraction off the mark there. Needs to get this one.
Well.
Some points on the board for this really good start from the All Blacks. Some great continuity and great speed of recycling.
And what's very evident off the back of that, Smithy, is how flat Cruden is playing. He's taking the ball really flat. He's not sitting deep at all. And two or three times he's already been quite happy to go into contact and take on those inside defenders.
Cruden's kick is right down the centre. And the All Blacks finally turn the big advantage into points, and they lead early by 3 points to nil. Black bench tonight as Dan Bigger prepares to make the kickoff, and just going the 10 metres and no more.
Back off Black.
Tipped back on the All Black side though by Reed, the skipper. And the All Blacks have had all the ball so far as Aaron Smith works it away for Ben Smith. And he lost it in the tackle. And so they'll play a scrum here. Ben Smith hit hard. Might have been by Toby Faletau, the number 8 forward.
Well, I know there's a mistake off the back of that, but I would think early concerns for the Welsh is not that the defensive system is showing any weaknesses in terms of being organised. They certainly have players there, but already we've seen with steps, Savia, Naholo, and then Ben Smith actually break tackles. And they can ill afford to do that against this All Black attacking machine.
Just an issue with Brody Retallick on the far side of the scrum, so that's why we've got the opportunity to talk about a couple of things, Justin, because one of the catchphrases Warren Gatland has used is be bold, fellas. Back yourselves. Be accurate, sure.
I thought that worked.
But be bold. Now, here's a chance to be bold early in the match. Big opportunity to go either way.
Yeah, absolutely. They're well set. I suspect, though, first scrum, the All Blacks will look to really test this Welsh scrum big time. I think the reason that Warren Gatland, you can see there, pensively looking at this first scrum, has brought in Gethin Jenkins is to solidify that scrum. All of his experience, 130 tests. There's only four players capped more in the history of the game than Gethin Jenkins. Because first of all, Smithy, if they want to implement that game plan and to keep the ball in hand, their set piece needs to be good.
Well, let's look how they've lined up, Justin, because at this stage they've got Jonathan Davies on the side with Callum Amos.
Thanks, fellas.
Okay, and then they've got Dan Bigger straight behind the scrum, really. He could go either way, or they could come off with the number 8. If they've got that platform to work with, Jamie Roberts on the other side with George North and Liam Williams.
And certainly as we look at it now, pan out to the right-hand side, it certainly is a great opportunity to the right. The left is well covered. But they certainly, with this setup, have created, if they get the scrum right, a chance. You can see that wide winger out there. Outside in the hole, like severe, I should say. And that's the big lump that is George North. So
let's give ourselves a little
a player
bit more
like that,
space,
he would just like to get a one-on-one early in the game, not two defenders coming at him, one-on-one. If they can manipulate that, Wales, and give him a chance to get into the game, will be interesting, that clash with Savia out there.
Give yourself space.
Well, he scored 27 test tries, George North.
Yeah, of course.
Against Julian Savia with 38. So what's that, 65 test tries between these two guys. So let's have a look at this first scrum. Gethin Jenkins is on the loose head on this near side. Rhys Webb is the halfback. And it's holding. And it's holding okay. So Faletau is able to deliver for Webb. And away they go. Drops a short pass off. It was a line ball into the arms of Roberts, and now they work it away across on the far side. Trotty up very quickly to make the tackle, and it's there again for Webb. Now, Wyn Jones and the All Blacks driving him back. The two lock forwards, Retallick and Romano, are there. An aggressive defence by the All Blacks as now Wales get it away. Here's Jonathan Davis, taken low in the tackle of Cruden. Faletau snaps it up just on the halfway line. First real opportunity Wales have had with the ball in hand as Reece Webb preparing to kick by the look of it. And away it goes. And it's a nicely weighted kick here, and Ben Smith's up there. The ball's bounced loose into the arms of Ken Owens, the hooker. And the ball is there once again for Bigger, and he delivers. Now they go wide again, Davis. Here is a chance for Liam Williams. Got through the first tackle, Williams. Pops it up for Davis. And 6 or 7 metres away as Webb gets there quickly. Now they spin it away for Jones. Coming wide. Got numbers here too if they can continue the move. Here's Amos. Gets it away. Faletau! Toby Faletau for the corner. And Wales come up with the first try of the game.
Well, they certainly do. And Amos did a brilliant job of just the last draw and pass. I thought George North had carried it too far. That way bringing the New Zealand defenders back into the mismatch that Wales has already created. However, it was the timing of the pass. Faletau hugged the touchline as well, put his hand up, knew that he was in space. This is the kick that Ben Smith can't quite gather. Lovely pickup, you'd have to say, there from Owens. They shifted it out. Sevier gets beaten by Williams, gets him well over the advantage line, and as they bring it back from that breakdown, watch North carry it. I just thought he maybe needed to shift it. He carries it quite a long way. You can see the overlap. Cruden's already panicking, wanting the hand up. Drip draws two players in. Faletau holds his width. Brilliant start. Great attack.
Yeah, a lot to like about that. And that little jink that went inside to draw Sam Kane, just momentarily held Sam Kane in that line of defence, meant he could not get across to cover Faletau at the end. But let's talk about what Gatland said. Be bold, yes. Be accurate, yes. So tick two boxes there. The kicking, the high kicking was accurate. They were able to contest. Ben Smith and the Holo got in a real mess, and Wales have capitalised, and here's one of the best in the business. He's a beauty, Dan Bigger. Forget about the antics. Just worry about the accuracy to make it 7.
Kicks at 84% in international rugby. And it is just away. But what a good start by Wales as Toby Faletau scores the opening try of the game. And George North made the run. And in the end, pretty much unchallenged for the corner. Ten minutes gone. Cruden down as far as Bigger. All Blacks try to wrestle the ball away, but it's there for Webb. Now they'll have to wait for Bigger to get back in position as they go to one little ruck.
Use it!
And Webb might do the job himself as he drills it away downfield. So the All Blacks looking to launch from inside their own half. And the ball dropped by Naholo. It wasn't an easy pass, but they've given the Welsh another opportunity here. Pretty much a scrum where the previous one was.
Exactly. It's the same spot. And the way they worked it last time to the right, as you see the mistake from Naholo, the pass was low. He couldn't quite gather it. It was Roberts that hit the short ball, but there was an opportunity. So Dan Bigger, you'll see him in behind the scrum. The way they worked the 8-9, and then Roberts came short. Bigger's out behind him, and there was space last time. So Bigger there, you can see him. Roberts, he's the one there, the first in from Bigger. He came on the short ball, nearly got through the tackle of Cruden, but the opportunity certainly is there for Bigger out the back behind Roberts.
Set. Stay in the competition.
Good, solid, well scrum. So Faletau, away it goes for Webb. This time he gives it off to Roberts. That was, again, bordering on forward. Looks on the inside for Bradley Davis. So Webb is there once more. All Blacks 10 out from the 22 on defence. And running interference. And so the penalty goes the way of the All Blacks. And an opportunity to clear.
Luke, make sure you attack the ball, not the floor, OK? Yeah. Yeah, I know, but you didn't come on it, so it was perfect. Those arms are easy to see,
and
mate.
A good thump downfield by Aaron Cruden.
Yeah,
Fellatau's the man. He ran across and out Ryan Crotty. You see Crotty in there. So line out untidy. In fact, very messy. And Smith has to go and grab it. Cole standing at the back of the mall. And Dane Coles takes it almost to halfway. Now Kano as the All Blacks rumble it up into Welsh territory. Picked up by Reid. Coles there again. As the All Blacks look to drag in the Welsh pack. Now they release it as Cruden works it away. Long pass goes to Naholo. Oh, he's stood up his man very nicely. Gets it back on the inside. And Cruden is about 15 metres away. Now the All Blacks to Naholo, who made the break on the outside. Smith reaches in. Ben Smith, now Fekitoa. Good tackle on him, though, by the halfback Reece Webb. Now the All Blacks come charging onto it through Kieran Reid. Smith gets it away for Romano. Aaron Smith again. Here comes another kick. Savia lining it up. Julian Savia. And the All Blacks scored their first try of the season.
Well, Aaron Cruden, you can see there, congratulating Julian Savia. Well, he should be giving Cruden a pat on the back as well, because the way that he recognised where the space was, it took him a little bit of time, but he had time. He sort of pivoted before he kicked. This is the break from the Holo. Just too much space. He puts the hammer down. Inside to Fekitoa. Nice covering tackle on Aaron Smith. But watch Cruden. He just looks, checks, turned it back on the inside, saw the space, and put it pinpoint perfect.
Yeah, a lot of things to commend the All Blacks with there. It was Naholo's first run. Hallam Amos gave him way too much room. He came in too quickly. And again there, George North was drawn so far inside the field of play that he wasn't able to protect two players on his outside. One was Dane Coles and the one was the try scorer, Julian Sevilla. And that was because of the strong running from the ball runners inside, attracting those defenders inside. So great continuity there, Justin. Really good try to answer back.
Yeah, very good. And as you rightly mentioned, Naholo just too much space. Cannot afford to give him, with his speed, that much room to move.
Pulled it away to the left, Aaron Cruden. So it's an unconverted try by Julian Savia. His 39th test try in his 42nd test match.
Yeah, I'll have a look.
And 8 points 13. To five.
Don't change your line. 13.
Just look at the work of Savia to keep his eyes on the ball. Never takes them off it. Look at that. Perfect. Gets it on the chest. And bangs it down.
Bigger kicks off. And beautifully taken down by Reid. Crowd not happy as Kane hands it off to Crotty.
Don't go in there. No.
Felt that Kieran Reid might have been impeded as Aaron Smith bangs the kick, which will come down around about 10 metre line in Welsh territory. And it's there and grabbed by Jenkins. Now Moriarty hands it across to Bigger. They're going to go wide, trying to get a bit of space for George North. And he's stood up, Savia, and he's got away beautifully. North, he fires it back in field, but he's thrown it forward. And
he's
going to have to go back. And George North just showing the danger that he can be. In fact, he was in touch.
Well, what I thought that he was going to do when he got this, this is Kieran Reid. It's just a contest between him and Fellatau. Probably Fellatau did grab him by the arm. But when George North went...
Play on.
As Wales bring it down from the line out of a quick throw. He was, went on the outside. I thought he was trying to go over top of Sevier.
Ken Owens. Live by a hooker for the Welsh. 17 minutes gone and Fellatau in possession. Already shown that they can be dangerous with the ball in hand. And Webb releases. Bigger. coming down near the 22, and in goes Ben Smith. Really committed himself brilliantly, and Ben Smith's in the clear, and he's got options either way. Goes wide, back it goes to Naholo. How's the speed? Waisaki Naholo.
Oh, Waisaki Naholo, yes, but Ben Smith. You want to look for some inspiration early in this match.
Not for me.
What a great catch under pressure from Ben Smith. Leapt into the air, and then he just put the hammer down. Probably opted, if you're going to be critical, for the wrong option to do the miss pass. But that's brilliant. Puts the hammer down. He's got players to burn. Sam Kane on the inside, Crotty. He went and chose Aaron Cruden instead of Fekitoa, but the minute that Cruden brought Naholo back on the cut, he was always going to have too much space. He, yes, a little stutter step to step out of the tackle, but brilliant from Ben Smith.
He might drop one, he might every now and then drop two, but he's never going to drop three in a row, is he? He's just unbelievable in that situation, Ben Smith. The Welsh were complaining a wee bit. They thought maybe he was given too much protection from Fekitoa under that ball, and one of their players was taken out. History now, as is the conversion, Nisbo.
Yep, it's over. 15 points to 5. And suddenly the All Blacks have bounced back. After the early try by Faletau, the two wingers, Savia and Naholo, have scored. Now bigger. As we get close to halfway through this first half, and Luke Romano, who's been strong early, crunches it up. Aaron Smith punching it down towards halfway. Fielded there by Williams, Liam Williams. Webb away for Bigger. Thought he saw a gap. Coles, though, closed it pretty quickly. Now Webb drops it off to Jenkins. Offside, the All Blacks. So playing under advantage here as Webb.
No advantage.
And no advantage.
13.
So you imagine early-ish in the game, that Bigger will line this one up.
Well, the recycle's pretty good, Wales, and a couple of times Malachi Fekitoa has been caught short of defenders with him. This is a great example of it. You can see there's only him and Naholo there. That was the offside. As the play went on from there, Fekitoa was forced to come in and get in the eye line because he had two players outside him, and they had created an overlap, Wales. So Fekitoa being in the eye line created Bigger to go to the contact instead, but they are managing to work their attack to create overlaps, Wales, at this point in stage, which is causing some problems out wide for the All Blacks.
He's got quite some routine, hasn't he, this guy?
Yeah, I already saw it, but not a lot we can do about it now.
First penalty attempt of the night is true, and the Welsh supporters in the crowd love it, and it's 15 points to 8 halfway through the first half. Cruden's kickoff. Claimed again by Dan Bigger.
Just home.
Away it goes for Moriarty to charge it up. Back now for the left boot of Jonathan Davis.
Yeah, good.
Safely into touch, but the All Blacks thought about going quickly.
Not now, 2 each. Just give yourself room, Samson, here's a middle.
Three tries already in the game. Room. Jonathan Davis missed the World Cup. Sadly missed it by the Welsh. As Coles goes to Reed, immediately taken down by Kane. Aaron Smith. And Jerome Kano charges it up. Naholo gets in close, looking for work. Reed again drops the pass off to Owen Franks. And Aaron Smith, well, he's lost it forward.
Pass forward. And,
ball
forward.
Turned over.
Advantage
so
over.
He's playing advantage and bigger hacks it away downfield. And Ben Smith has the remaining 29 players in front of him. And he plays it beautifully. And there's no real option to throw it quickly, but they're going to. Huge pass by Bigger, but it's not really going to do them much good. Now, Faletau, there's a bit of space out on the right for Faletau. And he very nearly got away from Richelli. Got it off to Jamie Roberts. Lovely counter-attack here. Jonathan Davis pops it over the top, and the ball's been intercepted and taken away. And somehow or other, the All Blacks have it back. And Cruden has to pop it and deputise. And he thumps it away downfield. And sits up for Faletau. Long sequence of play as Williams bangs it away, and it's up there, and now it's in the arms of Webb. Little kick and chase. The All Blacks, though, bring it under control through Sam Kane. Plenty going on at the ruck of the mall. It's lively in there, and Wales have it. Webb drops the pass off beautifully, and here's Liam Williams in a fair bit of space. Tried to chip it, and the All Blacks bring it under control, and it's going to be offside. Dane Coles wouldn't have known, presumably, that it came off an All Black player, and immediately he was offside. And Wales have a penalty. Long sequence.
Certainly was. Great breakout, Faletau. Presence of mind to free the ball, Jamie Roberts. And a timely intercept here from Aaron Smith. Boy, they were in some space, Wales. Lovely little pass from Reece Webb onto Williams. He had to try and beat Smith with footwork. He had to try and beat Ben Smith. He instead opted for a bit of a miracle kick. They've got the reward with a penalty off their good attack, Wales. But possibly if he had taken on Ben Smith, even a breakdown there, they had numbers flooding forward, they could have got more.
They've got to believe in themselves, because the way they're playing and the boldness they're showing from even inside their 22, that was remarkable, that breakout down the right, considering they were in all sorts. The All Black chase wasn't that bad. They numbered up quite nicely. So for them to get what they've got out of this, real confidence-building stuff. And Ben Smith's intervention with that foot there, they had a player steaming up on the left. That was a seven-pointer. Maybe it'll just be three.
Beautifully judged again by Dan Bigger. He lands his second penalty. 15 points to 11. The All Blacks in front.
You missed that look, fellas, have you?
Yeah. Cruden. Again, it's Bigger. He seems to be the designated catcher of the ball. Kano comes crunching in. The All Blacks try and drive over the top. And Wales have it. They've controlled it nicely. And there's a good thumping tackle by Kieran Reid, the captain. So now Webb. Maholo waits. Goes early. Can't control it, though. And he lost it forward, did Naholo. So advantage being played for Webb as they move it across. Samson Lee was the first receiver. All trapped in there. And penalty.
It's a big factor. Reece Webb, Justin, I think he's had a strong start.
He has, and that was an incredibly accurate kick, as we see the looks on both coaches' faces. I'm not sure who's the happiest there. But
he's not. He's absolutely
what he did was put that on Naholo. Without him being able to get any momentum forward to attack the kick, it basically, the kick went straight on him, and he only had to just try and win the ball by jumping straight up, whereas the Welsh player was coming forward. So he's had a brilliant start so far, Reece Webb.
Nice kick by Bigger, and so Wales swing back onto attack.
Oh, that's a middle, fellas.
Well, he's taken all of the kickoffs so far, has Bigger.
Who's in, fellas? Who's up? Full line out.
So Wales get to throw to their first line out, and it works nicely too. Again, a short pass, this time a thumping tackle. And the All Blacks looking to free the ball quickly as Coles hands it off. Cruden. Now here's Ben Smith. Ball stolen. Off goes George North. And he's put a foot in touch.
Oh, what a tackle. I think it was Brody Retallick needed to be made. George Smith, he was clear if Retallick doesn't make that tackle. Brilliant work from Jonathan Davis in the midfield. He tackled Ben Smith, got to his feet and won the ball.
Guts Wales! Wales open. Thank you.
W, blue, 7, 8. Reed with the line-out call. Coles with the throw. Romano grasping it. And the All Blacks efficient at set play as Coles holds it in the back. Not getting much traction here. And has to release. Smith makes the kick. North, nobody got a hand on that, and it fell nicely for Crotty. And so the All Blacks really got a free ball there as Aaron Smith works it away. Romano. Playing advantage as a Welshman impeding the ball coming back. Quick hands, Fekitoa, nice work. Naholo in a bit of space again. And off he goes, Naholo. He's got support. Oh, and he didn't find Ben Smith. He only had to let it go. And that was a certain try. And the advantage appears to be over. The All Blacks had an opportunity. And they didn't convert. So Owens releases. Taken up by Warburton, the captain. Now Weaver's in there directing the troops. And he gets it back deep for Bigger. And away goes the kick. This one is now in touch.
And that'll be Welsh ball, it should be. It's clearly in. Wow.
Alex.
Well, I think, I agree with you. I think Naholo's feet were in the field of play.
It certainly was. He wanted to play on. A bit unlucky there, the Welsh somehow.
The All Blacks blow a try there, boys?
Yes.
Bill 50.
Metallic at the back. Aaron Smith charging onto it goes Crotty. Right at midfield here. As Naholo got himself involved, handed the pass off. As the All Blacks getting close to the 22.
Away you come, all red.
Plenty of bodies in there, but it's going to be freed up for Smith. Now here's Naholo to Crotty. Spun out of the initial tackle of Bigger. The good pressure here, and it's bounced clear. And now the hack away downfield. Who's got the pace? All Blacks getting back. And first man there is Cruden. And he's happy just to let it go downfield. Fielded there by Bigger. Off it goes to Williams. And Liam Williams bursting through the two initial tackles.
He's got support.
He set it up nicely here for Webb. And the little halfback is over. Wales in front.
And they're up. They're high-fiving, and the body language is very positive. Why shouldn't it be? Liam Williams, stand up. I mentioned Ben Smith before. Well, anything you can do, Ben.
You might be right.
I can do as well. He broke through two or three tackles from there. Reece Webb ran a perfect line. And this time he made the right option. He drew and passed at the right time. He gets it here, not a lot on. Look at all those defenders here. Beats one, two, three. There's Webb looming up. Perfectly timed pass. Naholo's desperate. Webb's too quick. Wow, Wales, big time. They are in this game.
You don't see Brody Retallick miss a tackle like that very often, fellas. I've got to say, really. He was part of them. And honestly, that All Black defensive line there was pretty weak. It was pretty easy to get through, but I think the star of the show for Wales so far puts the icing on this one, because he's been outstanding. He's driven them around the park, and they are playing a great brand of rugby. Good luck to them, and they deserve this lead, one feels, although the All Blacks blew 7 at the other end.
So the try has been converted 18-15 after the All Blacks led by 15-5. Liam Williams and then Webb was able to get away from Naholo. And rightly so, the Welsh supporters Long way to go. 7.5 remaining in the first half. As Aaron Cruden, change of tactics. Oh, beautifully done by Reed. Now he gets support from Naholo. Kane works it away to Jerome Kano. And the All Blacks rampaging inside the 22. Aaron Smith got Becky Toa there, but there's plenty of defenders. And they drag him down, but he's got able to turn and get it back. Kano once more. All Blacks looking for quick ball. It's not that quick as Aaron Smith finds Ben Smith. Crotty. Good Welsh defence. Aaron Smith. Retallick lays it. Naholo, no space there. So Aaron Smith again for Sam Kane. Got through the initial tackle of Moriarty. Now Aaron Smith away for Cruden. Quick hands, but not held in midfield by Coles, who was coming on the angle. And the knock on.
It's wearing them down, the Welsh. There's quite a few of them down on their haunches at the moment because they're having some questions asked. Great kick from Cruden. Brilliant from Reed in the air. Takes it down. Where's the support on the inside? Just a little late, Crotty. You can see there. He was just, if he was up flatter and Kieran Reed could have got that pass away immediately, it would have caused the Welsh more problems.
I'm just waiting. Got some injuries.
You can see there. He wins that contest quite well. If he needs the support now, where's the next player? As they shifted across, short line from Coles. There was a gap there. They didn't quite get it right, those two, but good defence from Wales. What I've noticed, Smithy, is they are really being vigorous and confrontational at the breakdown. They're making it hard for Aaron Smith in there, and the All Blacks are not getting it all their own way.
And it's the reason that their attack has been so good and their finishing has been so good. They're backing their defence. The All Blacks are creating errors of their own with 8 handling errors as well. They won't be pleased with that. The turnover margin, there'll be quite some team talk. The first one for Steve Hansen and co in about 6 or 7 minutes time. But I venture to say, Justin, so often you see the All Blacks not vulnerable, but make the other sides vulnerable either side of half time. And this next 5.5, 6 minutes for the Welsh is the most important of the match for me.
Yeah, last one spot on. Yeah. Keep that space.
Second!
Watch on.
Very few scrums so far.
Bind.
Good opportunity here for Faletau to get off the back of the scrum to the right. Only one All Black defender there, Aaron Cruden.
Stay in the contest.
Again, holding nicely as Webb sweeps it away.
Just
bigger.
Yep.
Drills it away downfield and not out. So here is Ben Smith. Hands it back to Savia. Taken in a good tackle as the All Blacks work blindside. And they get it away to Reed. He in turn finds Ben Smith. Aaron Smith for Retallick. Smith again. Awkward pass, but well handled by Romano. And the big lock forward. He's been strong with the ball in hand. Now Aaron Smith, Cruden, looking to find holes close. Aaron Smith works it away for Naholo. Again, looks on the outside, this time closed down by his opposite number, Amos. Aaron Smith for Kane. Sam Kane lays it back. Aaron Smith again. Inside the 22 is Retallick, hands it off to Aaron Smith. Now Cruden. Fekitoa breaks the first one and then lost it. Was able to reach back and grab it. Went backwards. Aaron Smith, well, there was a gap there and Wales have exploited it. Here's big George North. Got to put him away quickly, and they do. And good work by Kane. Diving on the loose ball, but
number two has just jumped straight.
It's against Dane Coles. So yeah. Kane did everything right.
Kane did brilliantly. Yeah, Dane Coles, he knows. Yeah. He just went in, dived in to seal the ball off. But again, it's the breakdown pressure. The ball's not as clean as what Aaron Smith's used to. We've seen it spill out the back a few times. That's because Wales have got good body position. They're nice and low. They're on their feet, and they are making it hard work for that second arriving All Black player to make sure that the ball's protected.
Well, Warburton appeared to have forever to get and secure this. It was just nothing there.
Thanks, mate.
It just seemed a mess, didn't it? Really, and Warburton, just as the experienced player that he is,
six, mate.
Had it on a plate, and that was the turnover there. Now, here's a chance.
Six.
Big chance.
And their line-out's been functioning incredibly well, Wales. Getting good ball from it, clean.
Owen's the hooker. Faletau pulls it down nicely, and Wales have this. They're about 10 out from the 22. Now the All Blacks having to regroup as they endeavour to drive forward. Webb goes blindside, slips it away to North. He's been an ever-present danger out on that right wing side. And the All Blacks can't turn the ball over. Wynn Jones takes it into the setup. Wales building nicely. It's Bradley Davis stands over the ball.
Keep arriving up, Wales, drive up!
Just edging forward. Faletau. Now Webb looks to the back division. Off it goes, bigger, drops a little kick in behind. It's a beauty. Controlled by Smith, though he lost it. But Cruden tidied up.
One second.
And what's Wayne Barnes decided here?
Just want to check two things, Georgie. Just want to see the restart, but just whether or not there's a little tug of the shirt on the Welsh player, please.
Okay, just check the restart and if there's a tug.
And if there's a knock on, who carried it over?
Sure.
So restart, really.
Okay.
Well, they're not going to die wondering for a start off. Wales, lovely little chip from Bigger. Aaron Smith was fulfilling his role, so he's the sweeper for the All Blacks. So what they're going to look at, Aaron Smith definitely gathered the ball, then it was ripped. And it's whether Aaron, it certainly went backwards. And they're watching now, watch Davis, gathered by Aaron Smith. It comes three, and no, that's just part of contact, I think, in the tackle.
Well, the only player that could have grabbed the shirt was Aaron Smith as he went down, isn't it? There's only two players involved in this here. He never had control of it, Aaron Smith. Did he hold his arm back there? Did he?
Wow.
Could you definitely say he was going to score and beat Cruden there anyway?
Let me just tell you what I'm seeing now, Georgie. There's a knock forward there from Black. It's then hit a red player. They're both kind of grappling with each other. So, scrum.
Correct.
Red ball.
Correct.
Thanks, mate. Yeah. So, scrum, red ball. First knock on. First one, knock on by Aaron, scrum red ball.
Okay, so you heard it clearly from referee Wayne Barnes. He said they were grappling.
And correctly.
Yep.
Don't you agree?
Yep, absolutely.
You could slow any contact down in a game and there'll be that sort of grappling. So they've got that bang on, but boy, what an opportunity for Wales. And I tell you, they have made some inroads. The All Blacks should have some real concerns as we look at it to the right.
Well, if they use the flat pass to Roberts here, he might be unstoppable that close if they go right.
Yeah, Biggers changed his position, though. He started on the right instead of behind the scrum. Ooh, this is interesting. What do Wales do now?
Well, I think
just a free kick.
They've got to back their scrum here to try and drag this whole All Black eight together, and that's what's going to happen.
He wanted a gap, but he didn't.
Yeah, Roberts at 112 to 115 kgs. When he gets the ball, if he gets it, he's only going to have to travel about 10 metres.
Well, see, Bigger's job, as we looked at it behind the post here, which was a great shot, if they get it 8-9 right, okay, Bigger's job will just be holding the flankers. You can see there, so he'll try and hold the flankers, and then he'll look to get a short ball in between Crotty and Cruden, predominantly running at Cruden.
Right, in it goes to a stable scrum. Now it's there. They're going to come this near side, and Davis very nearly got inside Kano. Now Webb, and Webb goes away. Moriarty just tipped up and no more by Reed. All Blacks having to defend here right on half time, and Wales threatening to score yet another try. And they're going to have a go on the near side, close. Not there yet. Webb. Now they go to Faletau. All Blacks reading a little wider of the ruck. Webb goes across to Wynn Jones. They're opening up the angles, though. It's there again for Webb. wants to come back to this near side, the blind side, for Faletau. Drops it off to Amos. Fires in the field, but the flag is up. So the defence holds.
Here's the middle, fellas. Come off it. No quick lineouts. Good discipline. How many's in, fellas? How many's in?
Cole's looking to go quickly, and he does so. But
take it in again. Fellas, you haven't created gaps.
Wayne
you're
Barnes
offside.
Wants it thrown again.
Open the gap, please. Red, move. Open the gap, Red.
Half time is Willis. Next time dead, Coles goes. Retallick and Smith will bang this into touch. And they'll head to the dressing room. But Wales have the lead at the end of the first half. Two tries apiece in the game. And Wales leading by 18 points to 15. Let's go downstairs. And Melody Robinson with Aaron Cruden.
Aaron, behind on the scoreboard, what do you think has gone wrong for you guys?
Yeah, I think when we're in that half, we just haven't been able to hold on to the ball for long enough periods. We're threatening, but then we lose it at a ruck or we drop it and it just releases the pressure valve. So, as you said, Wales are playing some good rugby, but we feel if we hold on to it a bit longer, we'll be able to get the rewards.
Good luck for the second half. So there you have it. Wales have had a compelling first half, haven't they? They lead 18 points to 15 at Eden Park.
Everybody is ready to go. The second half of this game at Eden Park. First test. Wales against the All Blacks, and Dan Bigger gets us started once again. Lined up and taken by Romano, and he's got it up high. Now he finally gets it to ground. And Aaron Smith preparing to bang it away from inside the 22, and it's drifting across towards the line. Nicely taken by Williams, who's been a star turn at fullback so far for the Welsh. Now Webb away for the veteran Geffen Jenkins, and it's there again for Webb. Now Bigger hits it out of the centre field. Big Faletau. Now Bigger again to Davis. Taken down at the tackle of Crotty. Just a little breakdown near the back, and the All Blacks may have exploited this. They have. Aaron Smith goes reaching in and swings it away for Ben Smith. Now lobbed away across to Savia by Kane. Wasn't much in the game towards the end of that first half, Julian Savia. Aaron Smith, quick hands from Kane. And hello, we've got a problem.
Just take a second, take a second.
He's worried about Alan Wynne-Jones. Came barreling backwards there, right. I think it was a head contact.
Yeah.
Just make sure.
He was just being sensible, because you're absolutely right. Alan Wynne-Jones, when that contact happened, his head really snapped back, and then he hit the ground straight away. So Wayne Barnes was right there, saw the collision, saw his head snap back like that, and was just slightly concerned that where he landed was right by the ruck, could have caused more damage. So good, sensible refereeing, player safety in mind.
Okay.
Oh, yes, he did too.
Sorry, fellas, just checking. Scrum, Blackmore.
It appears to be all right, though.
Yeah, Blackmore.
It's interesting looking at the All Black bench, fellas. Bowden Barrett is up very, very quickly here in 22, and he's looking as if he's not that far away.
They're just clearing the dust away. And
these boys clearing the dust away. Wow, takes tracksuit off, Miss Bo, that is. Bowden Barrett.
Yes.
But where?
Crouch.
Well, I'm getting the word that will be for Savia.
Bye.
Julian Savia.
Set.
So maybe Smith to the wing, Barrett to fullback.
Yep, I would say so.
Stay behind Reece.
In the meantime, Reed controlling at the back of the ruck.
Use it.
Or the scrum. Told to use it. So Aaron Smith swings it away. Crotty. Oh, it breaks down. And looks like a double knock. It is a double knock. And this might be the moment, perhaps. Breakdown and play. Barrett is certainly ready to go. And up goes the board, Smithy.
Yeah, well, we'll just look at the way the All Blacks do form from here, because it will be a set piece. We'll get a good idea. Well, it doesn't look as if it's an injury thing. He missed that tackle on George North. Justin, straight out sub.
Yeah, he's good.
It looks like it. Ben Smith's just taken a knock in the meantime. You can see there the pass is behind him, and he gets hit hard by Jonathan Davis, who's been outstanding tonight defensively. He's a big lump in the centres, and he doesn't miss. And look at that, right beside him, Jamie Roberts as well. They've worked in tandem brilliantly to shut the All Blacks down there. Just winded, I think, Ben Smith. But yes, an interesting change. Obviously, one they had thought about the All Blacks when they put Beauden Barrett on the bench. What they will do as coaches and as a selection panel will say, right, if these things happen in the game, or we see certain things happening, where do we slot players and move and manipulate? So it won't be something that they wouldn't have thought about, and Ben Smith will take his place on the right wing, Beauden Barrett the fullback.
And the Holo across to the left. So,
crouch.
Yes.
Bind. Set.
Yeah, feeding the scrum.
Use it!
He's starting to twist a wee bit. Faletau, Webb. Off it goes to Amos. Surrounded by black jerseys. Ben Smith tries to hold him up. But it's there again for Webb. Jim Jones takes it up.
Forwards hold. Stop
now
Bruce.
Bigger. Barrett having to line up an early one. And he looks comfortable under the high ball. Does Beauden Barrett. Aaron Smith. Reed. Boy, the defence is up very quickly. That's Jenkins. And Wales have got numbers there, but the All Blacks now have it through Romano. Oh, he fires a loose pass. Tidied up by Kano. Now they're committing more players to the ruck, the All Blacks. But inside their own 22 as Cruden works it away. Here's Barrett. Goes wide. Smith with a bit of space on the right wing. Makes good contact. Plenty of time from inside his 22 for Liam Williams. He's not out though.
Oh, yeah.
So Barrett. He's going to be the first All Black there too, but it bounces loose and it's being claimed. So the All Blacks have it
first
back.
One,
no,
forward,
first
forward,
knock on
two
was made by Wales, down. And so they'll go to a scrum.
Interesting tactic too, straight away. The first kick they used, Wales, which was a very accurate one that Barrett got hold of, was straight at Naholo, even though he changed wings, Justin. So I figure they'll rate Ben Smith very highly, obviously, under the high ball. So Naholo could be a target.
Yeah, most certainly could be. Obviously, you change the back three and the dynamics and positions of those players. They have to adapt and adjust, catching the ball in the areas they're not used to, but Wales have decided to make their own change early in the second half.
Necessitated by that head knock to Alan Wynne-Jones. So he's down the tunnel for a concussion test. And it's a big moment for Ellis Jenkins. Back to Jake Ball. Not quite yet for Ellis Jenkins. Jake Ball in 19.
We're going to come on this side. Will.
So the All Blacks have gone quite directly from Aaron Smith straight to Ryan Crotty. They don't look like they're going to go that way with this setup.
Crouch.
Smith is in behind, though nice and tight.
Bones.
Cruden, Fekitoa, and you can see there Crotty. Is it Smith out the back and they try to get wide?
Stay close.
It's there for Aaron Smith. Off it goes to Cruden, and they go with a flat kick across field and Naholo. Didn't really get the bounce, Naholo, and so Wales have a line out.
There's replacements.
And looks three. Like a change three coming left. Up in the front row for the All Blacks.
18 to 3, so Charlie Falmawina makes his way on for Owen Franks. There's a knock on actually from Naholo. They're going to play the line out or a scrum?
Okay, here's the middle.
Yeah, looks like the line out.
Who's in, fellas? Five back.
Yeah, good points, Smithy. So Owens throws. Both teams have been pretty tidy in set pieces.
That's what
we're waiting. And another test coming up here. No, not Barrett this time. It's Naholo. Takes it nicely. just on halfway, and a wee bit of space here for the All Blacks as Crotty thumps it up into Welsh territory. Aaron Smith, inside pass, nice one from Retallick, and Joe Moody makes ground. Smith again releases. Cruden again drops a little kick in. Here come the chasers. Controlled by Williams, but he lost it immediately, and the All Blacks have the ball inside the 22. Retallick sets it up for Aaron Smith. Now here's Cruden. Cruden holding it up. Still going, Aaron Cruden. Now quick ball for Aaron Smith. He hasn't got the quick ball, but at the moment he's got a penalty advantage as Aaron Smith works it away wide. Becky Tawa.
Good tackle.
And intercept, but they'll go back.
Wow, what a tackle by Webb.
Wow.
Wasn't it?
Oh, yes.
Fekitoa, that close.
One on one. You saw Fekitoa get it, and he went on the outside break, which I really liked. This is the initial kick from Aaron Cruden. Plenty of All Black chases. He can't quite gather it, Williams. Good there from Fekitoa. And this here, you thought it gets on the outside, but Rhys Webb grabs a hold of the shorts, slips down to the legs, and nails the big centre. Watch him. Just gets a hold of the shorts. This is great in the ultra motion. Keep an eye on this, kids. You don't give up in the tackle. He slips down to the ankle, holds on by one leg, and one-on-one against a powerful centre from a halfback. That's a brilliant tackle.
Well, Cruden lines this up, and lined up on the sideline will be Wyatt Crockett, and that'll be for Joe Moody very shortly.
All Blacks don't concede 18 points in the first half very often. In fact, last time was in that wonderful test in Johannesburg a couple of years ago that they managed to win. So Cruden kicks the penalty goal, which draws the two teams level with 8 minutes gone in the second half.
Just confirming that change has been made.
So off comes Joe Moody, on comes Wyatt Crockett to play his 46th test match. And Bigger with the kickoff. Romano calls. Aaron Smith. And from inside the 22, gets it away nicely.
Line's yours, Black. Yeah. I'll give you time, you use the line. Who's in, fellas? Seven. Ready,
Patrick. Owen throws. Well, the All Blacks might have just about stolen this. And no, he's
got Romano.
Yep. For taking the player before he landed.
Yes, Moriarty, the number six.
And this will be a shot at goal.
Well, he won't have any problems. Yeah. You can see here goes Romano. He goes up nicely. Moriarty just grabs the arm. That's enough to just disrupt the line out. You've got to leave that player until he gets back down to the ground. You cannot interfere with him, even if it's a small arm grab like that. But as I was about to say, it's not a distance problem for Dan Bigger. He does have a prodigious boot on him, so you would think that the only issue here for him is just that slight angle, but boy, he can kick, and this could be another opportunity for Wales to get that three back.
So Alan Wynne-Jones comes back.
Thumbs up, two fellas on the test.
Thumbs up?
Yep.
So Jake Ball. Well, he might be required later, but Wynne Jones will be back on the field. In the meantime, Moriarty being patched up. Looks like a rib problem for him, and Dan Bigger gets it up, and it is away to the left.
22.
So a rare miss for Dan Bigger.
What's not playing?
And it remains 18 apiece.
Well, he's a warrior. Is Owen Wynne-Jones. His 100th test, as we've rightly noted, but he plays all the minutes as well, so that just enhances the fact that when he has played all those 100 tests, He pretty much always plays 80 minutes. Tough.
Cruden from the 22. Fairly short kick to give the All Blacks a chance, but North snapped it up. George North!
Great tackle, Bowden Barrett.
Somebody had to make a big tackle. Now Webb gets it away. Warburton was in the move. Now Davis, they go wide. The pass was a little bit flat. And Amos takes it to the setup. Nobody there yet.
No advantage there.
And he's gone back for a previous infringement.
A late tackle on Reece Webb. George North, I tell you. Bowden Barrett, when you're asked to stand up as an All Black, a winger, 110 kgs on the move on the outside break, and again the technique, as we saw before from Reece Webb, was absolutely perfect. And that tackle, Smithy, man, did it need to be made.
Well, he's been outstanding, hasn't he, George North? He's been just so penetrating tonight, the way he ran an angle there. Actually, Wales weren't happy about that. They thought Wyn Jones was taken out at the kick. Look at his motions down on the ground there. But All Blacks desperate there. Great tackle,
exactly.
Barrett.
That's a
and here's the offence there, and that's Aaron Smith on Reece Webb late.
He's landed two penalties already. Now he's landed three, and Wales back in front, 21-18. Minutes into the second half, and Cruden again. This time punching it a lot further downfield. And Bigger has time and space. And he's a lovely punter of the ball. And away it goes to the 10-metre line.
Well, Black's going again to the bench here. And it will be Patrick Tuopolotu for Luke Romano.
I'll go in 1 second. Who's in?
Jersey 19.
5 mark.
Short line out for the All Blacks. Jerome Kano is out in the back line outside Cruden. You can see him there.
Three replacements in the pack. And it goes deep and taken down by Reed. And quickly it goes. Smith. Off it went to Kano. Now they bring it back to this near side. Barrett. Off it goes to Naholo. Gets rid of his man. Gets rid of North. Not easily done. Aaron Smith. Rotella. Short ball for Kane. Aaron Smith again. Charging hard onto that is Wyatt Crockett. Now Cruden drops it off for Fekitoa, but the tackling is safe and sure from the Welsh. A little snipe from Smith, but there's no room around there. And so Crotty has to go in and delivers for Barrett. Drops a nice little kick in behind, but North read it well. He threw the pass to Williams, and down he goes in the tackle of Naholo. Webb thumps the kick away, fielded by Barrett. But look at the Welsh, they're up really quickly. Now here's Tuopolotu in a little bit of space. Aaron Smith again as Kane works it away. Barrett stayed in the line. Now Fekitoa with a bit of space. Good acceleration as Kane frees it up for Brody Retallick. Hands it off. Flat pass goes to Crockett. Got it away to Crotty. He in turn finds Crockett again. Now another kick through, but beautiful red. And he took it, Mark. Boy, that's a remarkable mark. And now he gets and bangs it off downfield, Dan Bigger. And what exceptional play.
Wasn't it? Dan Bigger. There certainly was a chance for the All Blacks again. The Wales coming up fast from the outside, so they're trying to block off those overlaps the All Blacks are creating. Dan Biggar was that player. He just reached up, took it one-handed, brought it down, presence of mind to call the mark, and then the quick kick away.
Cole's waiting for the call. Just five in the line. Retallick stretching up. All Blacks looking to drive off Retallick. Cole's controlling at the back.
He's
going to have to slip it to Aaron Smith.
Yes, Aaron, yes.
Which he now does. Sees a little opening on the blind side. Wasn't really much on in the end. And North. Held up by Kano. And it's coming for Webb eventually. And he's got the All Blacks slowing the ball down.
Technically, he's refereed it perfectly because Jerome Kano is there interfering with the ball. But in saying that, this is sometimes where the interpretation really doesn't make sense, because Jerome Kano, as much as anything, he made a good offensive tackle. There was nowhere for him to go. And I think sometimes in that situation, if a referee could recognise that the player could do nothing, that maybe a scrum is the better option rather than a penalty. But technically, under the laws of the game, you do get penalised for being there.
Let's just go back a stage or two. Last two times Aaron Smith's got the ball, he's had to kick. He's been forced to kick. The All Blacks have kicked a lot tonight, Justin, tactically, when they've been on attack. But I think it's more a testament to the Welsh defence.
Yeah, the Welsh defence have been aggressive. They haven't missed many one-on-ones, have they? When you think about this game, they have not missed one-on-one tackles. They've all been coming up, making good hits. Tell you who's been outstanding. That's been Gethin Jenkins. 130 tests. He's just on fire tonight.
Owen throws. Toi Pilotu got a hand in there. So the All Blacks win one. Now Crotty works it away for Becky Tower. Cruden ranging wide. Drops it off for Aaron Smith. Barrett makes a surge. Makes it up to halfway, leaves it there for Kane. Aaron Smith, he in turn drops it off, and the All Blacks look to attack from just on the Welsh side of halfway. Becky Tower again. There's Aaron Smith. Taken into contact by Kane. Penalty coming.
Number eight.
Against Faletau.
Look, I think you're going to concede the odd one at the breakdown if you're as aggressive as what Wales have been. Every now and then, you just get it slightly wrong. That time probably entered slightly from the wrong angle and ended up off his feet. But if you're going to be that aggressive at the breakdown and cause the problems that they already have for the All Blacks, you'll take that every now and then, that you'll get penalised, because it's worth it.
He's added a bit, Bowden Barrett, hasn't he? Just the speed at which he does things, the great footwork. So he was on very early. And speaking of coming on, it looks like his Hurricanes teammate might be on for a very special debut. Not a good night for one Savia, could it be for the other? And talking of goal kicks as well, when you're behind and the time is running out, that's when the pressure comes on. This is a massive kick for Aaron Cruden.
So you can see there, if that graph, the green ones show the successes. On the left side, the reds, not so good.
Well, he's well short here, well short. And Davis is able to clear it off downfield. Not into touch, though. So Cruden gets back and fields it. Barrett hands it off to Reed. And the All Blacks have it right on halfway as Aaron Smith swings it away. Barrett breaks down. Now a bit of space here for Becky Toa. Gets it off to Naholo. Kick and chase. Are those All Blacks on side? Becky Toa to Kane. Crotty right on the 22, looking for quick ball again. There's Smith. First receiver was Barrett. Cruden gets nailed.
Gethin Jenkins, I think it was.
But he was able to lay it back. And Barrett it is who takes it into contact. Crotty, first receiver, Fekitoa, Kane, frees it up, here's Kano, Naholo. Naholo still standing. Ball still in play, no. Flag up.
Yeah. Scintillating attack from the All Blacks, but equally brilliant defence from Wales. Here's the ball out the back, Crotty, presence of mind. Fekitoa gets it on, nice little kick from Naholo. Fekitoa wins the race to the ball. As they recycle it, look at this, as Cruden gets the ball, he gets Boomfa. All of Gethin Jenkins.
Arti Severa is on, test debut for him, famous night.
Well, there's plenty of talking going on. 20 minutes gone, 20 minutes left.
That's a great read from Gethin Jenkins to get out this third defender. He's got a very talented 10 who can step coming at him. He just shuts down his time and space and hits him hard.
How many is that? Six, man, yeah.
The Welsh got to be careful here. They blew that last attacking line out when they had a great chance to put some pressure on the All Blacks. So they've got to be much more accurate. Tuipulotu stole the last one.
New Zealand.
125th test match.
Yeah, I have been saying 130. That's what the British Lions included.
Owen throws. All Blacks try and disrupt it. He said that was a good contest. But Wales haven't. So Webb is going to go the bigger. And he's got it away nicely. Not a lot of room to work. But almost down to the 22.
They both had the ball. Who's in, fellas? How many, Kieran?
Well, think about some moments the All Blacks have been in the past. They've been able to come up with something pretty creative out of a line-out. Is this the time?
Cole throws. Reed has it under control. Got a little momentum going here as Coles has it in the back. Now Wales regroup. Still there, and Reed breaks away. 15 metres out. Here's Arti Savio on the charge. Takes it within five. Still there on the All Black side, Aaron Smith.
Advantage.
He's got an advantage here as Lynn Jones reaches over. Savia again, fighting his way downfield. Aaron Smith, away for Retallick. Very close.
Still playing advantage.
Dragging bodies out to free the ball. Aaron Smith reaches in. Reed standing wide, but they're not going to get the opportunity. It is a penalty. Aaron Smith tempted to go quickly here.
Number five.
And they're going to. So off it goes. Charge at the line.
Any reason I can't award the try?
Any reason why you can't award it?
Yeah.
Okay.
Naholo.
You want to see an impact of power. If he has got there, Aaron Smith just quickly tapped on the ball and he just burst onto it. Like a bullet he went at that line.
Yeah, it's pretty hard to think that he hasn't got there. Straight at Bigger, straight through Bigger. When Jones holding on. Yeah, that's on the line, no problem at all. That's really interesting, Justin, because you're 3 points
Bunzi
behind, you get a certain 3 points gifted to you.
Bunzi,
instinctive Aaron
There's
Smith,
no
or was Reed was right behind him. Was he saying go, 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 or what do you read? How do you read that?
I think it's that part of that leadership group, isn't it, which Aaron Smith is included in. The captain will back Aaron Smith. He'd head numbers to the right. He opted for Naholo. That's ambition. You've got to love it.
Converted by Cruden. All Blacks at the moment by four.
Still so much time, though. So much time, but Aaron Smith takes the opportunity. But I tell you, do not underestimate Waisaki Naholo, how hard this is to do.
He's just gone like an absolute bullet at the line. So much power.
Significant change to come up to. A little bit of sentiment about it. Looks like Gareth Anscombe's not too far away for Wales, fellas.
And how good was Artie Savera in that assault at the line?
Two great carries.
So biggest kickoff. Down it goes to Aaron Smith. And the little halfback bangs it away into touch. And what a big moment this will be for Gareth Anscombe.
I'll give you a time. I'll give you a time.
It will be for Hallam Amos when it happens. Where he'll fit in, not sure.
Six. Seven.
Well, that's Liam Williams, and he does not look good, does he?
No, he does not. Owen throws. Well, again, the All Blacks disrupt. This time it was Kano. But Wales managed to regain it, so Webb shifts it away for Lee. And the big tight end prop takes it in. Now Webb. And it's been lost in the tackle. Troddy got in, initially made the tackle. And Wales have lost control of it and conceded a scrum with 16 minutes remaining.
Oh, that's a big hit on Jamie Roberts, isn't it? All Blacks contesting well, Justin.
Yeah, they are. They've managed to steal two or three in this half. Need to sort of think about where they're going here. Wales wasn't a lot of opportunities to break the line there. There was plenty of All Black players waiting for Jamie Roberts, and the pass just on his shoulder didn't help. Needed to be right on the chest where he could regain the ball. Well, retain it, I should say.
Well, nervous times for both coaches.
Well, this is about the time when the last group of All Blacks fired up, wasn't it? The last 17, 20 minutes of test matches where they got themselves out of holes so often. But that is a different leadership group you're talking about. A lot of experience to dig them out.
First one, new
really interesting face for this new group.
Watch it.
The scrum it goes from Aaron Smith.
Use it!
Reed channels and detaches. Now Smith quickly puts the boot to it and finds a good deal of space too. Liam Williams. Nicely weighted kick this, and Williams really lost it. And it's been pounced on, and the All Blacks have possession. As Smith works it away, Webb's knocked it on. You read that well, Reese Webb. Boy, how good's he been?
He's been very good. Full of energy.
Who do you want next, sorry?
And to be fair, Gareth Davis on the bench, he can add some impact as well, but Reece Webb's had such a good game, you'd probably be reluctant to take him off the field, I'd imagine. But they look like they're going to make a lot of changes.
Wholesale, four of them. Gareth Anscombe looks as if he's going to go at the fullback for Liam Williams, not moving well at all now. 23 for 12, so that will be Scott Williams, and that's for Jamie Roberts. 17 for 1, 16 for 2. So Scott Baldwin for Owens, Rob Evans for Geffen Jenkins. You're right, he has been massive tonight, Geffen Jenkins.
Lost forward, scrum, black ball. Yeah, I thought we were.
All Black back division, having a conference.
Just get that knee up. Not pre-engaged, fellas, okay? On your first one, nice balance.
Well, they've passed the baton on now, and Wales have pretty much cleared the decks.
Crouch!
Dare I say it, the scrums have been very clean this evening. I don't think we've had a collapse or a reset.
Might have been in the very first one, I think, but this looks a bit untidy at the moment.
This isn't going to work.
Going to have to
just keep quiet.
Yeah, but you're by, Marshall.
It always was.
Here we are, fellas. Let's get that scrum. Hold on. Not too much of that extent.
Just so
not
passionate about good clean scrums, gentlemen. Love them. There's the All Blacks set up. So what they've been doing is starting quite narrow tonight, the All Blacks. So Ben Smith in behind Aaron Cruden there, and 12 and 13 have been quite close. So what they've been doing that for him. We've seen it a couple of times. So trying to draw the Welsh in to start tight. See how tight the Welsh are? Jonathan Davis there. And that brings in the option of the cross kick.
Crouch. Bind. Set. Start using Aaron.
So
Aaron.
Smith waits. Off now for the kick by Cruden. And he's going to find some space too. And now the bounce and a big contest.
No quick ones.
And Bowden Barrett tempted to go early. Wasn't sure whose ball it was.
Contest in
there. And it is going to be all black ball. Well, yes, it's a long time ago, isn't it?
How many fellas? Who's that?
It's the year that Sir Edmund Hillary climbed Everest.
Seven.
Very good stat, Nisbo.
Taken down by Kieran Reid as the All Blacks rally near the 22. Ball held.
He's fine. He's attacked the man with a ball. Who is it?
No, now it's Aaron, coming lost. Slowly for Reid, Smith. Off it goes. And trying to get through was Crotty. Aaron Smith waits again. Ball held up there just for the moment. As Kano makes some ground. Now Cruden hands it off to Famuina. Smith again. Has a little dart. Snapped up by Savia. Ball lost, but backwards. Now there's a bit of space. Reid, Kieran Reid. Under the bar goes the skipper.
Well, they get some reward, the All Blacks, for their last 10 minutes where they've been absolutely relentless, particularly in the 22. You'd have to say there's an element of luck in this. As Dane Coles goes in, the ball comes free, and because of that, it committed some defenders who didn't expect it. That's just the finish. The end of it before that was when the ball was out of the back of the ruck unexpectedly. Nice little pass on from Tuipulotu to Reid. He breaks one tackle and crashes over.
His hands have been good, Patrick Tuipulotu. He's done well since he's come on as well. So yet again, an All Black side finds strength and quality off the bench. And you've got a feel for Gareth Anscombe, who had the almost hopeless task of dragging down Kieran Reid that close.
Well, they're just starting to create a little space now. An 11-point margin.
Just there, he created really, didn't he? Tuipulotu, he's been good. So Aaron Smith's off. TJ Perenara gets a chance in 21.
Wales go short, try and regain possession. And they are going to regain possession. So Webb works it away for Moriarty. Davis sandwiched in the tackle. But Wales in possession, five out from the 22. Charging onto it is Rob Evans. Now Webb for bigger. Wyn Jones looking to create some space, finding a little room through the centre. Haven't really been down in this area for quite some time. Here's North. Got through the first one of Crotty. Had to be taken down by Naholo. Wales retaining possession well as Webb now goes wide. Warburton in the move. Tipped on. Bit of space here for Amos. Just running out of room. Got his pass back though to Jonathan Davis. And Webb goes again. 6 or 7 metres out. Carried up by Evans. Ball is there again for Webb. To Bigger. All Blacks didn't buy the dummy, though.
Stole the ball.
And they stole the ball. They turned it over. And so here they come. And the kick and chase. There's no one back here. And the All Blacks leading the charge, but beautifully controlled in the finish. Did really well, considering that Barrett, who's got exceptional pace, is one of the chasers.
Don't go in there,
but now Wales back inside their own half. Warburton is going to play halfback. And Bigger is going to kick. And he's found plenty of space too. And nice kick. He settled it all down.
There's some pretty tired players out there. That was some full-on All Black attack.
Not now, two for each.
Welsh attack, I should say. And then the turnover. The All Blacks kick deep. Look at the speed of Bowden Barrett. They cleaned it up really well, Wales.
Cole throws. All Blacks win it. Off it goes to Kano. Perenara fires it off. Bit of space here for Cruden. Ghosting his way through Cruden. They're lining up on the inside. Perenara! And the All Blacks in again.
Yeah, look at the pass, fellas. The last pass.
George, on your own play.
Right.
That four back inside.
Yes.
May have been forward. Have a look, please.
The last pass?
Last pass back inside.
The last pass, okay.
So Cruden's pass for Perenara. It wants to check. It looked line ball to me. Again, under the laws of the game, it's just about the release. As long as the release is backwards, the ball can travel forwards. Let's have a look at it. It's fine. His hands were always going backwards, Aaron Cruden. So you just watch his wrists. They shouldn't have a problem.
Georgie, that looks forward to me.
Oh, Justin.
Oh, actually, I think he's passed it backwards. It's just travelled forward, but came back out of his hands.
Show me again, please.
Okay.
Well, they've got a disagreement on here.
Oh, look, George. Watch his hands. Watch his hands. His hands are back. Doesn't matter if the ball travels forward.
Thanks, George.
Okay.
George Ayew called it.
Oh, no. Wayne Barnes doesn't like it. He says it's forward.
My call, Aaron.
He's overruled the TMO. You don't hear that very often.
He was in line.
Three,
that's why
four,
he asked, but
nine.
On the replay. So just so everyone understands, I know it's slightly repetitive here, but
it was my call.
As long as your hands are going backwards or even straight across and you're not going releasing the ball forward, the ball can still travel forward.
No worries. Thank you. Two, seven red. Seven red, you said.
So there it is.
Well, there'll always be a talking point, and that'll be one of the big ones later on tonight somewhere. Wales, three changes, 18 for 3, 19 for 4, and 21 for 9.
Well, they really have cleared the decks.
OK, yep. All new front row.
Well, I guess the other part of that, if we go back to the Aaron Cruden break, is the fact that the Welsh have been incredibly brave tonight. They have really stood up, and what's happened in this last 15 minutes because of the Cruden break really typified it. They are tired, really out on their feet, and that's why I think they're bringing their reserves on. Because the players that started are simply knackered. They cannot carry on. They've been run off their feet.
They've got a free kick, which has been taken by Faletau. And off he goes on a bit of a lone mission. He's got a pass away. And it's been grabbed by Faletau. He's going to do it on his own. How about that?
Unfortunately, I think he's in front of the kicker.
I think he's in front of the kicker, but I want to check, please.
Okay, so we're going to go to the TMO as well.
I think he's in front.
Was he in front of Gareth Davis when he kicked it?
Yeah, and in touch if he's not in front.
I think the problem was he passed back, but he had to kick so quickly he couldn't make any momentum, the kicker.
Check whether he's in front and then in touch.
Oh, yeah, he's well in front, isn't he?
Barnsley, he was in front of the kicker.
Yeah, in
offside.
Between the 10 and the halfway, yeah.
Correct.
Yeah. No try, penalty, yeah.
Well, two big calls in the space of a minute.
No try.
I think they got one of them, right?
So, Faletau stays pretty much where he is, and yeah, he's a good meter in front.
Yes, he is.
Tom, you got the line. Thanks, Matt.
Well, this has been a great start to the international season.
Oh, it's been a really, really good game. Sellout crowd at Eden Park. They've been entertained, and what a contest we've had. Great start to the Test series. Really sets it up. And it's not over yet.
Not over yet. 8 minutes left. Over 46,000 here tonight.
OK, keep the gaps in.
Great to see Nathan Harris back in Test rugby, Nisbo.
Isn't it just injured in Chicago a couple of years ago? Perenara hit hard early and couldn't clear it. So now Wales in possession, right on halfway. And they've got some fresh legs out there as well. As Bigger hands it off. And just on the All Blacks side of halfway. Gareth Davis now at halfback. Anscombe brushes past the Fekitoa tackle as Davis. Into contact goes Moriarty. Davis scooped up by Bigger. Now the kick through by Amos. And waiting for it and controlling it is Barrett. Plants it there nicely. Perenara has a look, see if a kick was on. It wasn't. Adi Savia slings it across. And now he goes to Holo in a bit of space. Holds it up nicely for Retallick. Retallick has support from Crotty. Crotty looks on the inside, finds it from Perenara. And the Welsh defence arrives. 5 metres out from the 22, Naholo.
Backwards.
Knocked it backwards. Back on the inside for Savia. Spins out of one tackle. Perenara. Reed gives a short pass off. Ball bounces loose, and now here's Pruden, though.
Knock on for
ball it's lost forward by Falmawina.
Knock on, is it?
Well, I know the game's not over yet, and we still could see some drama, but Smithy, there's not been many better on the park tonight than the All Black captain, Kieran Reid. Everything he's done defensively, offensively, he's been very, very good. One to single out for sure is having an outstanding game.
Yeah, well, they chose him as, to lead the side as a natural choice, wasn't it? I don't think anyone in the country debated the choice. But Knight for
it looks a bit different with that one.
Seta Tamani Valu in jersey 23, a debut. So both of the debutants get on tonight, Adi Savia and also the man from the Chiefs, who's been so impressive in the last couple of seasons. Yeah, but you're right. I mean, they said, will he be the same kind of leader as Richie McCaw? And a lot of people said, well, he'll be the same and he'll lead from the front and he'll say, follow me. And certainly he has done that tonight, absolutely outstandingly.
In the meantime, a problem. I think it's Gareth Anscombe. He's being attended to.
I think one of the turning points in this game, one was the defence of the All Blacks just prior to half time and getting out of that. But the Welsh lineout's gone. All Blacks have just murdered it in the second half and taken ball off them in key situations. And that was the set piece they relied on so heavily in the first 40. It was faultless.
Yeah, you're right. You're bang on, actually. And certainly, you'd have to say, have found their way out of a bit of trouble tonight, which will be good. More rugby to come. Wales are back in action against the Chiefs Tuesday, 14th of June, 6 p.m. New Zealand time.
Let's get our balance at both teams.
And then the second
really
test live,
half, so
the 18th of June, out of Wellington. 6:30, we'll be on air for that. And finally, the third test in Dunedin, under the roof, the 25th of June, on air again at 6:30 with our build-up. What a test series, and this is a great start to it, Nisbo.
Set up beautifully, isn't it? Wales have been highly competitive. They've still got a bit over 5 minutes to go.
Set.
And the All Blacks with that 11-point advantage. So when it goes from Davis, Faletau hands it back. Now Bigger swings it wide for North. Again, using his size to bounce out of the tackle. Davis gets it away. Bigger to Thomas Francis. All Blacks have turned it over. Some good work there. So here's Retallick. Holds it up. Retallick does well, but he throws an awful pass. Now Crotty drops it off to Naholo. Good defence by Gareth Davis. Here's Retallick. He's running right out of the 80 minutes as Perenara hands it off. Player right over the ball there for Wales, and they had every right to have a go for it. He held his feet well too. And very good play by Alice Jenkins on debut. And Bigger has carved off a good 50 metres.
Well, Justin, you mentioned the effort of Kieran Reid. I'll tell you, his opposite number hasn't been too foul either, has he? Faletau He's had a terrific 75 minutes.
He has had a terrific 75 minutes. Dynamic off the back, and I think quite comfortably, with greatest respect to every other number eight out there in the world at the moment, and there are some good ones. We've probably got the best two in the world on show tonight, and they've gone hammer and tongs. It's been a great contest.
Brody.
Scott Baldwin throws. Oh, and it's a messy throw. So the All Blacks, Harris got a nice touch, and here goes Cruden again, showing a bit of pace. Off it goes to Barrett. Oh, he threw a loose pass. And Wales have kept it in, and I think there's another player offside here as they go scrambling back after it. And Crotty, a bit of a wrestling match going on. And the All Blacks.
Scrum five.
And it's going Driven to be a 5 metre scrum. Gee, I'm not sure that player was onside.
I agree with you. He can't go back and check it, obviously. They had to get that real time. The inside pass didn't work, and he was slightly in front, half a step or two, but that's enough.
Here we are.
But they cannot go back unless there's been foul play or a scoring action. So Wales get an opportunity. Well, objectively and non-biased, we would have to say they probably deserve to finish this game with a little something, don't they, Nisbo, for the way they've performed tonight. Doesn't look like they're going to win it, but it would be nice to see them come up with something creative to really complement their efforts tonight.
Well, I tell you what, if they can do it in the next minute, the All Blacks still have to go down and kick off.
True.
So let's see what unfolds. So Davis will feed the scrum. And 30 seconds will go by.
Watch stopped.
Interesting setup for Wales. So Biggers in behind Jonathan Davis there, you can see.
We're going to come away from that.
And they're quite tight, so what they'll try and do here is bring all three of them to the line so the All Blacks can't see them there, and that man in the transition role, that makes it difficult, and perhaps Amos comes into it as well. He's directly behind the scrum. They certainly look like they're going to try and go through close, tight, around the Cruden Crotty area with that setup. Or they'll bounce out very quickly and try and attack wide of Naholo, who's under the post. You can see him there. It's a great shot of where he's defending.
So it's going to be a free kick, and they're going to take it quickly. Davis. Now Wyn Jones. 100th test match. Evans has a go. Reed gets out, tries to get out of the road. Now the new player, Ellis Jenkins. Well, the ball's gone down, dropped, and turned over. So the All Blacks free it off. And here's a bit of space for Ben Smith. Now, here they come. He drops the pass, Ben Smith, off to Tamani Balu. And Perenara swings it wide, Retallick. Wales have come up quickly, so he held the ball and took the tackle. What a pass it is, too. Now it goes wide. Here's Naholo in a bit of space. Got away from one, Naholo. And he threw the pass, and he gave it away to a Welsh player. It's there for Wales, but it's going to be slow. Swung away by Bigger. Just a minute remaining in the test match, and Wales will be reluctant to kick it from here. All Blacks trying to rip it away from Amos. Carried on by Davis, knocked on. Well, the All Blacks have got one last shot here.
And what you won't see out of shot is George North is not great nick out on the right wing here. He was involved in the big tackle on Naholo, I think.
Yeah, he actually managed to get through. George North did Naholo. And in the desperation of trying to get a hold of him, he hurt himself. George North, he's pretty tough, though. He's battling with what looks like that taped up leg of his, and he's determined to carry on, which you would have to say typifies what the Welsh have been like tonight. Look at those run meters. Broken tackles, six, I should say.
Okay, let's go then, fellas.
He's been good.
Thank you, thank you.
So we're into the red. Siren blows. Perenara to feed.
Bynes!
All Blacks' narrowest winning margin against Wales up until now has been 19 at home, that is.
Okay, but I'm just talking about
so
your
Wales will
body.
Certainly keep it under that tonight, regardless of what happens here.
Look at Ben Smith over there. He's right over there by the trainer, and he's just about on, he is actually on the outside of the touchline. The All Blacks have gone really wide. You can see him there. He looks like he's just hanging out there as being taken off the field, but he's actually in play and ready to go, Ben Smith.
Set.
Reed holds.
Use it.
Now it goes to Perenara, and he goes wide, quick hands. Tamani Valu on the charge. Good run by the debutant. Now Perenara sweeps it off the ground. Here we come. Falmawina holds it up, and Harris. He scored one on debut, and he scores another one.
Oh, and stand up. If you're a front rower anywhere in the world, anywhere in New Zealand, stand up and be proud, because as the ball swung back to the left-hand side, it was three front rowers that managed to finish off the movement. Brilliant hands from Crockett. Charlie Falmawena, the draw and pass. Lovely run from Tamani Valu. The ball from him, from Cruden. Cruden got hit hard and stayed down, so he wasn't in his first receiver. Instead, look at this from Crockett. Out in front, draws in two defenders. Charlie Falmawena, the other prop, onto his hooker, who holds a difficult pass. Gotta love it.
Sum it up, one word, Justin, and we've said it how many times in the last five, six, 7 years. It doesn't matter who's in charge, who the captain is, bench. And the bench scored that try. Have they been good or not tonight as well?
Absolutely, good point. The bench has made an impact, Nisbo, hasn't it? It really has lifted the tempo of the game.
Yeah, but it's no longer a 15-man game. It's a 23-man game, that is for sure. And Nathan Harris, well, he's had to be patient. That is fantastic. Wales will be disappointed to have conceded. This makes it look as though the All Blacks have been superior all over. That is far from the truth.
It is. Yeah, it does flatter the All Blacks to scoreline, but this is their strength. They certainly do come home with a wet sail, no doubt about it. They pile points on in the last 15, 20 minutes of games. Wales would have known that.
So here's the last act of the game is Cruden, and he's made a lovely strike, and over it goes. At the same time, the final whistle blows, and Kieran Reid, it's his All Black team now, and he's led them to victory against a gallant Welsh side. Final score of 39-21. So what a contest it was. The first of three test matches. Welsh ahead at half-time, but they were only able to kick a penalty goal in the second half, but they stayed in the contest until about 10 minutes out, and the All Blacks have run away with a couple of late tries. Right, let's go down to the field of play.
Well, Kieran, the delight on your face is apparent at the end, but it took a long time for that smile to come. It was a tough night.
Yeah, I think, you know, exactly what we thought it was going to be. The Welsh were fired up, and I guess we maybe started a bit too well, you know. Boys are pretty eager, but then realised what test match footy is about. You've got to work really hard, and proud of the lads, we dug at it and came out in the second half, a bit of attitude.
Yeah, key moment just before half-time too, you held them out, which at least gave you some confidence going into that break.
Yeah, look, we had the confidence. I think we just need to remind ourselves about what we're going to do on this field, you know. It's a hard work, and it's, you know, just putting your bodies on the line, which we probably didn't show enough in that first half.
They were quite strong in the first half on their line-out. Their set piece looked pretty good, but you managed to get a lot of it in the second half, and that was one of the big turning points.
Yeah, I think, you know, we're just a little bit off the mark in that first half. But, you know, I think we've got a great line-out, and the boys who came on, I think, had a big impact in this game. So, you know, the bench did really well.
We've said it over the years, haven't we, so often, bench in the last 20 minutes. And you used Bowen Barrett very early, but as they came on, they all contributed.
Yeah, they all did. So this is a 23-man game. It's a 32-man game, you know, to prepare us for what we do out here on Saturday night. So whole squad's, you know, come together pretty well. And We'll take it. Plenty to work on for next week.
How do you feel, eh? It's your team now. 10th test as captain, but it's your team. How do you feel personally?
Oh, I feel great. It was certainly a pretty proud moment to run out in front of the boys. But this is it's a good team. We're just building. We'll get back to the drawing board on Monday, and we know we've got a big test again down in Wellington.
Okay, travel well to Wellington and celebrate well tonight. Well done.
Thanks, Smitty. Cheers, mate.
So that's Eden Park. On to Wellington they go, and then Dunedin for the third test. But the All Blacks scored 5-2. They were behind at half-time, 18-15, but they produced a very good second half. Let's hear from Sam Warburton now with the Welsh point of view with Smitty.
Sam, well, the scoreboard says 18 points, but I'm not sure that's a fair reading. It was a tremendous effort.
Thank you. Yeah, no, we wanted to come and play some rugby. We knew we couldn't come to a place like New Zealand and be conservative and hope to win by edging, penalty kicks. We knew we had to score tries, and our counter-attack was pretty good in patches, but compared to New Zealand, you make one mistake and it turns into 7 points, and two mistakes turns into 14 points, and they're pretty ruthless. But the good thing is we got another 2 weeks to have a crack again, and we'll come back next week hopefully better.
The theme to going into this game, to beat these guys on this soil here, was to be bold, and you did that from defence through to attack.
That was the message for us, you can't just turn up and try and play safe and win a test match like this. You've got to be pretty brave in some of the decisions you make, try and throw the ball a bit. And we did that probably more so than we would back in the Northern Hemisphere. And it paid off for us. We got some pretty good tries. Just a few defensive issues we need to tighten up. And disappointing to give away 7 at the end, which makes the scoreboard look a little bit ugly.
Yeah, it does. And a little bit false as well. A couple of other issues maybe. The line-out, they seem to get your line-out a wee bit more in the second half.
Say that again, sorry.
They got your line-out a wee bit more in the second half.
Yeah, I thought the tempo they brought to their lineup was great as well. They were in and out straight away. So defensively, we'd have to set up a little bit quicker. But, we knew coming here, there's not going to be a whole lot of set piece. The ball's always kept on the park in the kicking game. And it's not going to be a massive set piece game. You're not going to get more than 10 lineups in a game like this. But, maybe the lineups we do have, we need to make a little bit more of them.
So you go to Wellington, you go to Hamilton. Obviously, it's a big night for you guys here in Hamilton on Tuesday night. But you go to Wellington, out of this, what do you take?
Score some tries. We played some great stuff, and that's what I'm pleased about, is that we took some chances and they paid off. But we're playing the world champions here, two-time world champions in a row, and we give it a good crack, but it's not good enough for us. We want to come here and massive focus on getting a win. We're tired of being heroic losers. I know everyone back home feels the same, so we're doing everything we can behind closed doors to get a win, and it's something we're desperate to do.
I can't fault you for effort tonight, wherever they watch around the world. We'll see you in Wellington. Terrific effort. Thank you very much.
See you next week. Thank you very much. Cheers.